Hello students, in this lecture we will learn that how capacitor discharge ignition system works. Okay, we know this thing that ignition system of SI engine is a system by the help of which on time the spark is developed between the electrodes of a spark plug so that the compressed charge can be ignited. Okay, so to develop a spark between the electrodes of a spark plug, it needs very high voltage, could be between 20,000 to 30,000 volts. Okay, so there are many types of ignition systems. One of those is CDI or capacitor discharge ignition system. Okay, so what is the principle of this CDI system is that in simple we can say that we have to charge a capacitor. Okay, and exactly on time that capacitor, that charged capacitor, is discharged through an ignition coil. Okay, so what is the job of ignition coil? That it converts low voltage into very high voltage pulse. Okay, low voltage pulse goes in the ignition coil and it converts into high voltage pulse at the exit. Okay, so what happens that this discharging capacitor is actually low voltage discharge. Ultimately, over the exit terminals of the ignition coil, very high voltage is developed that is sufficient to develop the spark. So this is what the principle: charge the capacitor and exactly on time. Exactly on time means we want the spark exactly at the end of compression stroke. Okay, however in practical case there could be difference, but ideally exactly at the end of compression stroke the spark has to be introduced. Okay, so exactly at the end of compression stroke the capacitor is discharged through the ignition coil so that high voltage can be created. That high voltage is subjected to the spark plug electrodes and by this way the spark is developed. So let's learn that how the actual circuit works. So this is the complete schematic circuit diagram of CDI system. Okay, it consists of a capacitor, you can see, and that capacitor is charged by the help of a small generator, you can see, which consists of an exciter coil and a spinning magnet. We know this thing that whenever a magnet spins inside coils then EMF is developed in the coil. Okay, so whatever EMF is developed in the coil, the two terminals are connected to the capacitor. Okay, and in between there is a diode. So what is the job of this diode? That EMF can only go in one direction, means by the help of this generator the capacitor can only be charged. Okay, but in case this capacitor wants to discharge, this that is not possible, because what happens, the diode confirms that the current will go only in one direction. In case this capacitor wants to discharge, in that case the current has to go in reverse direction, that is not possible. So this is a sort of valve, electric valve you can say. Okay, so this bottom circuit is the charging circuit, which consists of a generator and a diode and the capacitor. Okay, now you can see this top circuit is the discharging circuit. Okay, so the two plates of the capacitors are there. So one plate is connected to a SCR switch. Okay, and other plate is connected to this ignition coil. You can see that this is the ignition coil. So ignition coil actually consists of two coils, primary and secondary. It is a sort of step up transformer. Okay, so in case the number of turns in the secondary coil are more than number of turns in the primary coil, in that case what will happen, it is a sort of step up transformer, it can increase the voltage. So you can see that this is the discharging circuit, that this plate is connected to XCR and ultimately in series this is the primary coil and ultimately ending with the second plate, first plate SCR coil and second plate. So by this way the circuit is completed. Okay, now what is this SCR? The full form of SCR is silicon controlled rectifier switch. Okay, now what it is, it is a sort of electrical switch. Okay, here I am showing that in default it is in open circuit. Okay, in default the SCR switch is in open circuit, but in case it is electrically triggered then it will become closed circuit. Okay, so this is the job of SCR switch. So you can see that this SCR is connected to a trigger coil. Okay, this is the trigger coil, and to the left hand side of this trigger coil there is a pulse rotor. Okay, what is a pulse rotor? That pulse rotor consists of a very small magnet, so when it rotates the magnet also rotates with the pulse rotor. Okay, so whenever this magnet comes and aligns correctly with this trigger coil, then a very small EMF is generated in the trigger coil that is sufficient to make this SCR circuit to become as a closed switch. I already told you that it is a sort of electrical switch. In case electrically triggered, it becomes closed switch. Okay, so this is the job of this pulse rotor. So exactly on time the magnet comes and aligns with this trigger coil, so at that time the SCR switch executes, and what happens, the circuit completes. So it runs the current through this primary coil, and the magnetic flux are developed in the primary coil. So those magnetic flux are linked with this secondary coil. So change in flux develops EMF in the secondary coil. Okay. So by that way, high voltage is created, because I already told you that ignition coil is a sort of step up transformer. So high voltage is created between the two terminals of the secondary coil. That high voltage is sufficient to develop the spark. Okay. So let's start how it works. Imagine that this magnet is continuously rotating and this capacitor is charging. Okay. And this is the end of exhaust stroke. Okay. You can see this is the exhaust valve open and end of exhaust stroke. E means this rotor, this pulse rotor. Okay. This is the end of exhaust stroke. Okay. Now what happens? This capacitor is continuously charging. Okay. And this SCR switch is in open mode, because I already told you that until unless it is electrically triggered, okay, it remains in open switch state. Okay. Now next is, after end of exhaust stroke, there will be suction stroke. So you can see it has sucked the charge inside and the magnet has reached over here. Okay. Remember this thing, that rotation of this pulse rotor and the rotation of crankshaft are synchronized, so that exactly on time this magnet aligns with this trigger coil, and exactly on time the SCR switch executes and high voltage is created between the electrodes of the spark plug. Okay. So this is the end of suction stroke. The charge has been sucked. Now next is compression stroke, and we know this thing, at the end of compression stroke, ideally at the end of compression stroke, the spark has to be introduced. So next is, what happens, that this is the end of compression stroke. So at the end, you can see now the magnet has been aligned with this triggered coil correctly. So a very small EMF is generated in this triggered coil. That EMF is sufficient to change the state of this SCR switch to closed circuit. You can see initially it was in open form. As soon as some EMF is generated in this triggered coil, then it becomes a closed switch. So when it is closed switch, now whatever charges are developed between the plates of capacitor flows through this primary coil of ignition coil. So in the secondary coil, high voltage is developed. Okay. These elliptical lines are actually the development of magnetic field. Okay. So when magnetic field or magnetic flux links with the secondary coil, so magnetic flux change takes place. So due to that, high voltage is developed in the secondary coil. So that is sufficient to develop the spark. Okay. So like this way, on time, the spark is developed. Now next is, what happens? Again, the magnet has been removed. Okay. Pulse rotor is continuously rotating. Okay. Now again, the SCR is in open circuit form. And in that time, what is happening? The charging of capacitor is taking place. Okay. Because this generator is continuously developing EMF. So now the charging of capacitor will take place. Now what is happening? Work has been ended. After working stroke, there is exhaust stroke. Okay. Still the circuit is open because magnet is not aligned correctly. Okay. Still the capacitor is charging. Now there is suction. Okay. Charge has been sucked. Still SCR is in open circuit form. Ultimately, when compression will happen, at the end of compression, now the magnet is correctly aligned. Okay, so that small EMF is generated in the trigger coil. Now the SCR is in closed circuit state. Okay, so whatever charge is developed in the capacitor is discharged through this ignition coil. High voltage is created and a spark is developed. So this ignites the fuel. Okay, so like this way, the entire circuit works. Okay, and the spark is developed. So in cyclic fashion, this circuit continuously works. Okay, it is like this. You can see that suction, okay, compression, at the end of compression a spark is developed, and then working, and when working is happening, then capacitor is actually charging, and then exhaust, again it is charging, again suction, it is still charging. When compression ends, entire charge is discharged through this ignition coil, high voltage is created, spark is created, fuel ignites, okay, then working, then exhaust. In this way, the CDI system works to develop the spark inside the engine cylinders. So one question might be appearing in your mind, that I told you that how this ignition system works. Okay. So imagine that engine is running and ignition system is working. But how to stop it? The question is how to stop this ignition system, because when we want to stop the engine running of this engine has to be stopped, then we want to stop this ignition system. So how this stopping is done? Okay. A key more is provided, an electrical switch more is provided in parallel to this SCR switch. You can see in parallel connection to this SCR switch, a key more is provided. Okay. So what happens when we want to run the engine? In that case, the key is open. Okay. And the ignition system is working, as I told you the entire story. But in case we want to stop this working, then actually we have to close this key. So in case this key is closed, now what will happen? When this magnet, small magnet, will align correctly toward this trigger coil, at that time the capacitor wants to discharge through this primary coil of this ignition coil. Okay, but since this key is closed, now the circuit is short circuit. So capacitor cannot discharge the charge through this primary coil. So no spark will be developed between the electrodes of spark plug. Okay, by closing this key. Okay, so hope you would have understood that how the CDI system works. Thank you.